Welcome all, and today I'm going to show you one positional strategy. You might have seen a lot of intraday strategy, indicator-based strategy, price action-based strategy, right? Let me quickly summarize what you guys might have seen on online videos, right? This is a Cipla chart in front of you. In intraday basis, you might have seen the strategies of 15-minute crossover, right? Then super trend strategies, RSI-based strategies, right? MACD, a lot of strategies, right? Price breakout, right? Now I'm going to introduce one positional strategy. This is a Cipla chart in front of you. You can apply this strategy on any stock, guys. Let me go to display and select an Heiken Ashi. Don't go for normal candlesticks. I always study with an Heiken Ashi to get a refined and non-noise signal and the chart pattern, right? So what to do to trade in a positional basis. Always the very first fundamental is always you should come from the larger picture to the smaller one, right? The way larger picture behave the same way or the same traits are inherited by the smaller picture. Here I mean the larger picture by the daily chart, weekly chart, right? Monthly chart. These are the larger frames. And slowly, slowly, you have to come down to hourly 30 minutes and 50 minutes as per your requirement, right? So whatever traits are there in a larger frames, the same traits are getting inherited in their smaller counterparts. Let us see how. Here I have selected a daily chart, right? Now you have to mark your support and resistances levels. I think all of you guys know how to mark a support and resistances. The stock which has come many times on a particular level, that is called as a support or a resistance line, right? I would say this is comfortably a support or resistance line, guys. You always have to eliminate the spikes, okay? The spikes which are coming in the market, that is nothing but an emotion or a fundamental news related to it. So whenever you are dealing with a technical analysis, I request to you all of you that you always avoid these spikes, right? Now on the upper side, this is the comfortable resistance, guys, for Cipla, right? Somewhere here. So this is the support and resistance line for Cipla, right? Then I have to trace a trend line, right? I think you all of you know how to trace a trend line. A line is formed with the two dots, right? Keeping this in mind, don't try to concentrate on any other dots to make the line align and to make all the points coming on the line. You always have to mark from the bottom. This is my bottom point. You can avoid this noise, guys. Always avoid the noise while you are dealing with the technical analysis. This is the noise, I would say, because of some fundamentals or the market pressure it has pushed down, right? So avoid this and mark your trend line. I would select this point or comfortably this point, avoiding this noise, right? And this is my trend line. Now the advantage of marking trend line is when you are trading positionally and trend line is broken at this point, right? The stock has started moving down, right? If you can see, the stock has started moving down. Now you have to concentrate on this point, guys. This is the strong resistance level on the upside, right? When Cipla has broken this trend line at this point of time, it has started moving down. Now these are your observations from a daily frame. You have to write it down, all these points and the observation. Keeping it back of your mind, you have to shrink your frame to the hourly basis, right? Come to the hourly basis and observe what has happened with Cipla, right? Again, you can go here and mark your trend lines, right? These are your trend lines. Only join two points, guys. Don't concentrate on any other points. It may be coming on the line or may not be coming in the line. Only mark two points, right? You should able to mark these two points. Here it is, breakout has happened and stock has gone down, and again it has come to the trend line, and after breaking it out, it has started moving up. Now to give a more better picture, I would go and mark Fibonacci level on this chart, right? How to mark the Fibonacci level? Go to the topmost point, go to the lowest point, okay, and this is your Fibonacci level. Now on right hand side you can see the 50%, 38.2% and 61.8%. These are the crucial level and where the stock has seen hovering, right? Exactly hovering at these levels, right? After breaking out this, the stock has started moving up. This is the picture for your hourly chart, right? Now, keeping this in mind, you should move towards the 30-minute time frame, right? This is your 30-minute time frame. Now, I will go and apply my studies, same studies of trend line, Fibonacci and support and resistances to collect more better points, more better levels for these particular stocks, right? So I'll go and draw a trend line first. This is trending, comfortably trending. It has broken at this level. It has formed a double top at this level and market started falling down. Now there are chances that if it is breaking this level, Cipla will plunge from this level to this level first. And if it is still going down, it will respect these levels on a further downside and it may go further down. There are chances that from this 61.8% level that Cipla may arise again, right? This is the picture of 30 minute frame, guys. Now to again enhance your studies, you can go and draw Elliott waves, guys, okay? Elliott waves are nothing but the wave formation in this fashion, right? This is first wave, this is second wave, this is third wave, this is third wave, and this is the fourth wave. The condition for the second wave is when first wave is formed, second wave should not break this support level, right? It should come somewhere here or here above this point. The condition for the third wave is it has to break this resistance level of the second wave and it has to go up. It may be somewhere here, it may be somewhere here, doesn't matter. The only condition is it has to break this level. This is my third wave, and when it is retracing back, the fourth wave should not break this level, this support level, right? So it may be somewhere here. Now after getting you 1, 2, 3, 4 waves, the market will retrace in ABC fashion. ABC in such a way that A is not breaking this high, it will be lesser or equivalent to this high. That means it is a double top condition, guys, right? And B is breaking this support level. B is breaking this support level, and C is rising up again, but not above this. If it would have broken this level or A would have broken this level, then market would have gone up. So this is the ABCD retracement when of Elliott waves. You can go and apply this level on the chart to refine your studies. Already you have got the points on your larger frames and you are started coming to the lower frame, guys, the 30 minutes, 15 minute frame. To refine your studies, you can go with the Elliott waves, right? Now, if I apply at any point of time my Elliott waves, I would get a better picture, right? Here, if I apply here at starting of the trend, if I try to apply the Elliott waves, this is my first wave, this is my second wave. Second wave condition, the low has not been broken. So second wave I consider till this point. My third wave, right? Third wave is this entire. This has broken this resistance level. My fourth wave has retraced back, right, till this point. The condition is it has not broken this support level, guys, and it is exactly following my trend line. Now my A, this A level has broken this level. A wave has broken this level. So I would have gone buy at this point when it has broken this fourth wave. This is my first wave, this is second wave, this is the third wave, this is the fourth one, and my A wave has broken this earlier resistance of the fourth wave, right? And I have gone by at this point. But my B wave has retraced back and it has not broken this support level. So I have a tendency that market will go up. There is an intuition or a tendency of Cipla that it is trending well above my trend line. It has not touched my trend line again. It has respected my level of 581, which I got from the earlier frame guys, and it has respected my 61.8% level. So since it is not coming to this level, if it would have come to this level, it would have gone down by breaking these two strong resistance levels, right? So this is the analysis for my 30 minute frame guys. So keeping this at back of my mind, I would quickly go and coming to the more smaller frames. I will go to the 15 minute chart now, right? And will give a better picture of the what stock is doing with respect to its parents. The parent here, I mean the bigger frame. It inherits all the traits from the bigger frame to its lower frames, right? So here double top is formed. Here again, I can go, this Fibonacci levels are ready made to me guys, right? So here I can go and plot a trend line again and mark my support and resistances level. Here what I got a double top here, right? So if I draw a trend line at this level, I will get something like this, which is very much breaking at this point. And I'll try to make my studies along with the Elliott waves here again, and I'll accumulate the more points for Cipla to make my trade a refined manner. So for positional trade in Cipla is I should go on a short side by looking at this double top and breakout at this trend line, which I got from larger waves, larger frames, right? And the Cipla is definitely going to go down after this 593.8 levels, guys, right? It may go down till this level, and further it will go down to the 50% level. So this is the complete analysis of Cipla. What you have to do, you have to keep it in mind the larger frame, then come to the smaller frames, accumulate the as many points as you can get from the Fibonacci, as well as your support and resistance studies and the Elliott waves, and keeping those points in mind, you can take your position, trail your trades along with the larger time frame support and resistances. Guys, weekly and daily support and resistances are more stronger than its smaller counterparts, right? So this is the strategy, guys, and this works for any stocks. This is, I would say, a study, not a strategy. You can apply it on a positional basis and trade comfortably. If you have any doubt, you can reply us, right? And we'll try to solve it. Fine. Thanks a lot. Thanks a lot for watching this video. And let me tell you guys, you are giving a lot of response to our videos. So it gives an immense pleasure to us. And I always go and develop a quality video for you. So it will be beneficial for your, not only for your investing, for taking a decision into the trade. So thanks a lot for giving a lot of response. Thank you very much, guys.